Hello, my dear children. Today, on this particular day, that means on Sunday, the 2nd of the February 2020, I'm simply gearing myself up for some new discussions of some new words pertaining or denoting God. In the previous class, I threw light on a host of words, on a number of words which were directly or indirectly related to God. So rest of the words, I will interact with you, or I should have discussions with you. Lots of words are still there, which already been cut. So lots of words are there, which I have already left, unfortunately, untouched. And I already just gave the commitment to you, just when I will be taking your next class, that means today's class, I will be discussing the rest of the words, which simply refer to cut or the denote cut. Simply, I am just like going to tell you, we dash our nails, we dash expenditure or expenses. You can also call it expenses. We dash stones. We dash hedges, HEDG. We dash electricity or power. We dash harvest, HARVEST. We dash harvest. So you just like look at these two. So we dash electricity, we dash harvest. Remember, number one, we dash nails, we pare nails in the sense of cutting. But remember, cut should not be used. Instead of cut, you have to simply prefer the verb pare here if the plural noun nail or the singular noun nail is there. Number two, we dash expenses or expenditure. We curtail. The verb is called curtail, C-U-R-T-A-I-L. So what is the meaning of curtail? Curtail means we should reduce or cut down. Its phrasal verb is called cut down. We should reduce or cut down. That means we curtail our expenses or expenditures. Then we dash stones. We hew out stones, H-E-W, hew out. Another interesting verb comes. For the noun stones, we dash stones means we hew out stone. Hew out means cut or dash. We hew out stones. Then we dash hedge. We prune hedge. P-R-U-N-E. We prune hedge. Hedge means the something that we put around our house for the protections of our house from the stray animals or the stray cattle. Then we dash electricity. We snapped electricity. S-N-A-P, snap. You can also use cut off. Another particular interesting phrase or another interesting phrasal verb that can be the best suited here is called either cut off or snap. Then we dash harvest. We reap harvest. R-E-A-P. We reap harvest. So reap, this verb goes with harvest. Snap or cut off goes with electricity. Simply prune goes with hedge. Hew out, also in the sense of cutting, goes with stones. Another word, curtail, which means reduce or cut down. It simply goes with expenses or expenditure. Another interesting verb is they are nails. So when you use the nouns nails for the cutting of nails, instead of use cutting, please go and prefer the verb pair. We pair our nails. But remember, here another word is the pair. What is the spelling of the pair? It is the P-A-I-R pair. Pair means two. Any two is called the pair. I have a pair of spectacles. That means I have one spectacle. But as the spectacle has two lenses, we simply call it a pair of spectacles, pair of trousers, pair of binoculars, simply pair of shoes. But here, the verb pair. So remember, these are the words. These are the words simply referring to the meaning of cut. So we use pair our nails, we curtail expenditure, we hew out stones, we prune hedge, we snap electricity, we reap harvest. But remember, curtail, this particular verb is used only if you want to cut down or reduce your expenses. So these are the rest of the words. I simply just like went through in order to convince you of my different types of the words simply denoting cut. So here, most of the words, the most of the nouns, particularly most of the nouns, that simply go with the varieties of the verbs, with the different sections of the verbs, simply refer to the meaning of the verb cut. Cut, this particular word cut. Remember, suppose if you say, we dash the tree. We dash the tree. You can use the verb cut down.
Yes or no? So when you use the verb cut down, only for cutting down a tree, instead of cutting down this resolver, you can also use we felled the tree. Remember, here felled is the past simple. You will be surprised or you will be very troubled and distraught to know that why is such type of verb is there? And why do we use such type of verb in this particular sense when it refers to cutting down of the trees or comes down to cutting down of the trees? When you cut down the tree, remember, this particular phrasal verb simply goes with the verb tree. When you cut down the tree, that means you fell a tree. When you cut down a tree, you fell a tree. So fell is the present simple form. When you add the, when you add ed as the suffix or the morpheme to the verb fell, it becomes your past simple tense. Remember, that is the second form of the verb. So when you cut down the tree, that means you felled the tree, but never use we felled the tree. Fell is the present simple, whereas its past simple is by adding ed to the verb, that means felled. So when you felled the tree, that means you cut down the tree. So here I simply gave you just a 6 to 7 important verbs simply referring to fell. Remember, when you remember got moustache, M-O-U-S-T-A-C-H. So when you caught a moustache, remember we use the verb twirl. We twirl the moustache. So far my knowledge goes, so far as I remember about my previous class, I have already given you the twist of the things or the lords of the words or the host of the words, simply various types of the verbs that go with various types of the noun referring to cut or denoting cut. I think that these types of the verbs referring or denoting cut must have been completely understood by you, and I do also sincerely hope that you don't have any such problems while dealing with various types of the words simply denoting to cut. In my next sections, I will go with some another interesting verbs, another interesting groups of the verbs of the host of the verbs. So what will be these verbs like? These verbs will refer to the words of movement. It will be the words of movement. You can also very interesting say that these are called walking verbs or moving verbs. Walking verbs or moving verbs. Walking verbs or moving verbs. That means verbs denoting movement or verbs denoting walk. We call it walking verbs or the words of movement. These are the verbs I'll be telling when I'll be taking your next class.